Hey guys, this is Justin. In this video, we're going to go through a full demo of the new 2 and 4-port ATU KVMs by TE Smart. If you're not familiar with what makes these so great, check out the last video for the highlights. Likewise, the video following this will be a complete setup tutorial and some common troubleshooting techniques. A couple key points before we dive in today. If you need to convert video signals like VGA or DisplayPort to HDMI, make sure to use a list of tested and approved adapters that we have on our website. Most adapters will not work in a KVM environment, so we compiled a list to save you guys some headaches. Also, these units today are for only single monitor setups. If you're looking for a dual monitor setup with a bigger extended desktop, check out the videos that we've linked in the description. All right, let's go ahead and jump into today's demo. There are four ways to switch inputs: the push button on the front, the hotkey commands, the remote control, and mouse gestures. When you use the yellow push button on the front, the KVM is going to cycle up to the next input. Since we're on input 1, which is our Windows PC, we're going to press the button, and we're going to go to input 2, which is our MacBook Pro. You'll notice the selection LED goes from 1 to 2, so that's another way to tell which input you have selected. If you want to use the keyboard to switch inputs, you'll use the hotkey triggers. The KVM can use either the scroll lock or the right control key. So right now we have the KVM programmed with scroll lock, and let's say we want to go to our Xbox, which is number 4, we press scroll, 4. Another way to switch is using the remote control. This is a very simple device, and you just press the button for the input that you want to go to. So if we want to go to number 1, which is our Windows computer, we'll press number 1. The M&P buttons do not have any functionality, so you don't have to worry about those. And you will need to pick up a battery if you want to use this, because unfortunately, we're not able to ship it with a battery at this time. The fourth and final way to switch is using what's called mouse gestures. These options will only work if you have pass-through mode turned off, so it's the least common way to switch. To turn it on, we'll press scroll, F12. Now, when we double tap the right side of the screen, we're going to go up an input. And if we double tap the left side of the screen, we're going to go down an input. Let's go ahead and turn the gestures off so we don't mess up our demo here. One of the best new features of these KVMs is called Passthrough mode. It gives you better mouse and keyboard compatibility, so we recommend that you leave this on all the time. You'll know when it's off when this mode LED light is not activated. To turn it on, you'll press scroll, F2. Now you'll see the mode light has come on, and when we use our multimedia keys like volume up, volume down, you can see that we have multimedia control of our computers. The KVM can also automatically cycle through the inputs by pressing scroll, spacebar. Now the KVM will go from 1 to 2 to 3 to 4 automatically. And if you want to change this time interval from the switching, you're just going to do scroll plus or minus. And when you're done with using the auto switching mode, all you're going to do is hit the escape key and it'll turn that back off. Now, if you want to turn the KVM's beep off, that's pretty annoying, you'll press scroll, F11, and that puts the KVM in silent mode, and it's not going to make any more noise until you repeat that pattern. Lastly, if you want to change the hotkey trigger from scroll lock to right control, you press scroll, F1. Now, you'll use the right control key in order to switch. So let's go back to input 1. We'll hit control, 1. And if you want to switch back to using the scroll lock key, you'll just press control, F1. Many customers are going to need to use more than one USB ports for things like jump drives, webcams, or headsets, or even a printer. Since the KVM only has one standard USB port, you're going to need a powered USB hub. Here, we've connected a headset and a webcam so that we can do conference calls on our PCs. Also, you can use these same devices with your gaming console, as long as your gaming console is compatible for those. When connecting the USB hub, always make sure to plug in the power first to the hub, and then connect the hub to the KVM. One area a lot of customers get tripped up on is how the audio works with a KVM. The KVM is going to receive the audio over the HDMI connections, and sometimes your operating system is not going to automatically select the correct output. To fix this, you're going to have to go into the audio settings of your operating system and select the output that looks like your monitor. If your audio isn't working, make sure to try all the outputs that are in the selection box, because sometimes it's not really obvious. So if we go here to our Windows computer, we can go down and type in sound in the search bar. We go to the sound settings. There's a little drop down at the top here, and we select the LG Ultra Gear, which is our monitor today. And now you can hear that we're getting audio out of our speakers. Likewise, if you have an input device like a microphone, This is the same area. You'll come here. You'll look for the mic to test out. We'll tap our mic here. Yep, you can see that our microphone is working as well. Now let's go ahead and jump into Zoom and let's just check everything in Zoom as well. Load Zoom. We come here to our video. Yep, you can see us right here. And our audio, we can tap this again. Yep, and now we're getting audio into Zoom, so we'll be all set for a conference call as well. One critical consideration when planning your KVM environment is to take into account that the KVM only switches devices that are connected to it. So if you're using a Bluetooth device, you're going to need to use a Bluetooth dongle that plugs directly into the KVM. Typically, most Bluetooth devices will pair directly to your computer, and if you do that, it's going to bypass the KVM. So just remember that the KVM can only switch devices that are connected to it. Anything that is not connected to it, it can't see, so don't expect it to allocate it to whichever input you have selected. All right, that's it for today's demo. We're up next with a complete step-by-step setup tutorial, as well as some troubleshooting techniques. Thanks and have a good day.